Welcome, friend, to Life and Liberty Radio. I'm David Householder, here to encourage your pursuit of happiness. You and our partners exploring our shared spiritual journeys. Together, we're dreaming and working for a free society. Tell others today about our adventure in faith and freedom. So breathe in, open your mind, lift up your spirit. Let's get started. We tend to think of prayers as lists that we have for God, kind of to-do lists for God, and we don't really have a vocabulary for describing our encounter with the Creator. And what we're going to look at today is how the church from the Eastern Mediterranean, the Eastern Orthodox Church, looks at the whole encounter with God and what happens during prayer and how God changes us, how the Creator works on us. Because east is east and west is never the twain shall meet, but they're going to meet right here in this podcast. So we're going to talk about how there's a three-legged stool of spirituality when it comes to prayer. One of those legs is working on our ethics, our morals, our ability to go out and change the world, our prophetic sense of right and wrong. And during our meditation and prayer time, we try to improve on that. If you look at Samuel Johnson or Benjamin Franklin from the late 1700s in their autobiographies and biographies, there's always this sense of striving bit by bit towards, in their prayer life, a better way of being, more moral, more ethical, more caring about one's neighbors, more following God's plan A, you know, that kind of stuff. Ethics. The other part is growing in wisdom, the second leg of the stool. Growing in our wisdom, our understanding of what's going on. And the Bible talks about Jesus growing up when he was young, growing up in wisdom and stature. That's the leg number two. And the third leg is that of the encounter with God and God actually transforming us physically and spiritually. And that's left out in the West, which is unfortunate, because in the Eastern Christian Orthodox Church, it is sort of the main point of connecting with God. They have nothing against the ethics and morals, one leg of the stool. They have nothing against growing in wisdom. In fact, before they read the Bible lesson, they always say, silence, wisdom, and they have got a long and strong and deep wisdom tradition. And we're very appreciative of that. But they believe that a stool to stand up had to have three legs. And we need to have another leg. And that other leg is called the actual encounter with God. It's the old Christ community and content trichotomy, so to speak. And every youth pastor knows you have to balance the social, that would be the ethical, how we interact with people, the wisdom or content, the Bible lesson, learning, growing, and learning our heritage. And there's also Christ or the encounter. And those three have to be balanced. If you're doing ministry, you want to make sure people have experiences of the supernatural, that they grow in friendships and sociability, and that they live out their faith, that they're kinder, gentler with people, that they work for those things that are on God's short list. So they work for justice, they work for freedom, they work for all of those kinds of things that are key in the story of the Bible, especially that of freedom from slavery and freedom from sin, death, and the power of the devil. So these three legs are very pronounced in Eastern Orthodox thinking, and the most important of the three is that encounter with God, because that encounter with God changes us, according to Eastern Christian thought, not just ethically, but ontologically. Now, I'm using a big philosophical word, but ontological means ontos, our being. It changes who we are, and not just in some vague sense, but physically, in the sense of every cell of our body. It changes us. It makes us into different people, bit by bit. And the Bible talks about being transformed from glory into glory. And our biggest problem is our bodies are mortal. And the Apostle Paul talks about the mortal putting on the immortal. And this isn't just some vague spiritual sense. The Eastern Christians believe that we become more like God when we are close to Him. And if you look at the parable of the the prodigal son, you see that his power and his ethics improve as he is closer to God. In other words, the whole prodigal son story, the younger son leaves the father and goes away, and the farther from the father he is, the farther from the source, the farther from the creator, the more poverty he experiences, and also the worse behavior. The closer he is to God, the less his behavior even matters, because he apologizes for what he's done when he's far away, and the father says, hey, don't worry about it, you're here. What's lost is now is found. And the truth is, when you're with God, you're perfect. And I know that sounds crazy, but it's true. How could you possibly be broken in God's presence, because his nature takes over? You say, well, you're saying you're becoming God? No, I'm not saying that at all. There's a creator of this universe. Something brought this whole universe forth, and it wasn't many, it was one. This is one creation, so we have one creator. But the truth is here that there can't be more than one, and we can't become that creator. We can create, but we didn't bring this world forth. We got dragged into it without any permission. And it's an incredible blessing that we were brought to life, and we need to honor human life in all of its forms, because it's such an incredible miracle, the gift of consciousness, of language, of connecting with each other as we do right here on these podcasts. So it's all about the whole life and liberty theme. We're entitled to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. So when we look at the importance of this encounter with God that actually changes us, we become like God. The Greek word for that is theosis, becoming like God. And that doesn't mean that we become equal with God, or that we change to become gods. That's not the point. We're not the creator. We can co-create, but we're not the originators of this place. And we can't possibly bring into being something like this, although we're able to manifest all kinds of things through faith. And according to the New Testament, that's what faith is all about. But as we look at this thing, the best illustration for this is taking an iron poker that you have by your fireplace and sticking it in the hottest part of the fire. What will happen to that poker? That poker will turn the color of the fire and will also take on the temperature of the fire, but it will still remain a poker. And just like you and I remain human beings, the closer we are to God, though, we take on his color and his temperature, we take on his attributes. We don't become the fire, but the fire affects us, and we become affected by it. And so the purpose in Eastern Christian thought is theosis, is spending a lot of time in God's presence and having that actually change us, to mold us into something else. And that's not just in some vague imaginary sense, it's a physical thing. We should be feeling God in every cell of our bodies, and we need to glorify God in our bodies. So that's theosis, and I would invite you in your prayer or meditation time, whatever faith family you come from. I come out of a Christian tradition, and that makes the most sense for me. That's my spiritual language. But whatever faith language you come out of, I just invite you to invite the one creator to just infiltrate every cell of your body while you're praying, and open up every part of yourself to the creator and just see what happens. And you might experience what the Eastern Christians have been talking about for, you know, almost 2,000 years. Have a great rest of your day, and session 63 will be coming up in one day. Well, that's all for today on Life and Liberty Radio. Thanks so much for sharing this part of your spiritual journey with me. Now, the views on this program are not necessarily those of my advertisers, sponsors, places I work or do business with. They're purely my own, but I'm sharing them with you, so share your ideas with me. Write me on Twitter at Liberty House, LibertyHous, no E. Until next time, let's continue dreaming and working for a free and spiritually grounded society.